All right, firing off round two, and it looks like a mulligan to me. And this looks fine. I think that's both of our white cards. Bone splitter, turn one. Well, it's probably not as bad as our opponent's, or the last opponent's bone splitter. Even though that one did also crush us, so I don't know. Sprite? No? Blind spot giant? That could be big. But it's probably... we're gonna get a good advantage off our Helix if he tries to go for it. Oops. Actually, why would I suspend that? Let's see. Four turns. Next turn I cast Rebel Arc. The turn after that I probably cast Valkyrie. I guess I am suspending this. You've got a 6-3 that can't attack or block. Alright then, I guess I have no choice but to untap and Revel Arc. That's a good card right now. Didn't play a land. Four spells in hand. Alright, I had a Carvalkyrie go. That's funny. If I had Valkyrie in play, I could use it on that to get it when he sacrifices to the Echo, but then I would kill my Valkyrie. Just a weird little combination. Another giant. Well, that's gonna be my giant pretty soon. He's thinking about exchanging the bone splitter. I would be pretty happy if he did that. Alright, attack. Activates Helixer guy. I'm doing it right now just so I don't have to worry about any instance on his turn. And I think I'll go ahead and play Shell Dweller too. That way I can and block that if I need to, for whatever reason, and then I can still get control of it on my next turn. I'm sure that he won't be able to deal with this and play a giant, but... Actually, if he had take possession mana, then he could do both those very easily. And I guess he could Echoing Truth this. And then cast it. Well, a one mana giant could make it happen. Oh, and an Echoing Truth. that case, I might just block. The Shell Dweller, yeah, it's not that exciting. I'd rather have five, or I'd rather have the six life in this situation. So I guess we're gonna take the. I guess we have to take the blind spot giant. So it means we're gonna be taking three damage. What if we played a little more conservatively? Just attacked with just the angel and just passed the turn. Giving him essentially no good attacks. I like that better, actually. You just can't attack into this, into the Valkyrie. Alright, he tanked for a bit there and decided on just changeling, probably pass. He played a land, so that means he drew a land this turn. I think now I will take this. Yeah, that's definitely gotta be right. So I could attack a little more aggressively now. Yeah, I think I just put him. A lethal next turn. I guess. Well, he still has the changeling that he can interact with, but. That's perfectly fine. Yeah, I don't want to attack with a Warspike changeling, I think. He would. It would kill him guaranteed next turn. It's not even guaranteed. There's not a lot of benefit to doing that. It just opens me up to more trouble. I have no idea why he's making this attack. I have no qualms about blocking. I'm going to go ahead and first strike it. And I could even gain control of the giant. Yeah, let's go ahead and do that. So he has to sacrifice something else now. Or no. Either way, I'm getting the giant, so it doesn't matter what he has to sacrifice the giant, I guess. Wait, what did he do? He sacrificed the land? Okay, I don't know how that makes sense. Valkyrie is no small thing. Nothing to sideboard once again.